Today we are doing a soil test from J.M. Fortier's The Market Gardener. And this is a quick and easy test you can use to determine your soil composition if you don't want to pay for a lab soil test. And yeah, I have to talk to the camera. That's how you shoot a video, Gooby. So, side note, if you have not read the Market Gardener book, I highly recommend it. Even if you are not a market gardener, which I am not at the moment, there's a lot of useful insights for just improving your gardening success overall. So let's jump in.
I'm jumping into you.
So determining the makeup of your soil composition is important because it lets you know if you need to tweak anything. And having good soil composition is absolutely critical in your success as a gardener. It will make the rest of gardening so much easier. So there are three types of soil, essentially. There's clay soil, sandy soil, and loam. So the first soil type, and the type you really want to be your goal, is loam. Loam is the perfect mixture of clay, sand, and silt, and it combines the best of all the types. So it typically has good fertility, good water retention, but at the same time it offers plenty of aeration and good drainage. So here is an example of fairly loamy soil. It's not perfect, but we started with dense clay and we've been amending these beds for years. So you can see we got a good amount of rainfall last night and the soil is damp, but it's still fairly crumbly. I can just kind of stick my knife down in here. Things aren't sticking together. And that's due to the mixture of the different types, the sand and the loam and the clay. The next soil type is sandy soil. So you can tell if you have sand because it's very loose and crumbly. It tends to dry out very easily. And when you try to hold it together, it won't stay in a bowl. This is an example of sandy soil. This was actually a load of topsoil that we brought in to amend our clay soil, and my little guy has been playing with the extra in his dump truck here. But you can see how sandy soil, you can actually see the sand in this, but it typically will be very crumbly. So this is wet and it still just crumbles apart like sand. And you'll typically see quite a bit of like gravel and even small stones in this. It's pretty sandy, huh, Bubby?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cause I just filled up this for you.
You filled this up for me?
Yeah.
Thank you. Sandy soil can be challenging because it does tend to drain and dry out so quickly. So you'll want to amend it by adding things like compost and well-aged manure, as well as making sure to add fertilizer in small doses throughout the season to kind of combat the issues with leaching of nutrients. And the third soil type is clay, as demonstrated here. Clay is possibly the most challenging type to work with, and you can tell you have clay because it's wet and sticky and will easily form into a ball. Guys, show them your balls of clay. You show them? Okay, you don't have to go right up. Bubby! You don't have to go right by the camera. But as you can see, we've just dug some up out of our yard. This is our native soil before it's been amended. And it is stereotypical clay. Clay is, as I mentioned, it's very sticky, it's very dense. It tends to have poor drainage and poor aeration. The one saving grace about clay is that it's usually fairly fertile, but the nutrients get locked up in that sticky soil a lot of the time, so you need to work with it to make it available to your plants. To amend clay, it's really good to add a lot of things like sand, peat, compost, well-aged manure, kind of anything that's gonna add loft and organic matter to the soil is gonna help, anything to break up that really sticky, dense soil texture. So yeah, this is an example of what this clay soil will do. Just form a perfect little ball. It's great for kids' sculptures. Not so great for gardening in. And when this dries, it'll get really hard and you'll see those big cracks through the soil surface. So to do the soil test as outlined in the Market Gardener, you're just going to take a mason jar and you're going to put about 2 inches of your whatever soil you want to test in the bottom of this jar. So I'm going to go around and get a sample of each of our soil types. So So the next step is to just fill up the remainder of the jar with water. Put in a teaspoon of dish soap, and the dish soap is going to act as a surfactant and help separate the soil particles into layers. Shake these up really well. And just let them set for a day to allow the layers to separate. Okay, so we've let these jars sit for a day, and we have clear separation of the layers on each of these. So this is our clay soil, and you can see here we've got a layer of silt and a big layer of clay. No sand at all in this one.
And this is a clay pot I made from the natural clay we have in our yard.
So yeah, this is what I meant, that this clay soil is really great for kids' sculptures, not so great for gardening, because this is what it does when it dries. That's literally like a clay pot right there. This was our sandy soil. And you can see here, this big section is sand, there's some silt, and there's the tiniest little ring of clay here at the very top. And this was the closest that I have to loam soil here on our property. And this is not an ideal ratio, but it's better than the others. So you can see we've got some sand, some silt, and a small amount of clay here at the top. What you'll see if you do this is that the bottom layer is going to be your heaviest stuff. So it's the sand, the rocks, that type of thing. Your sandy particles are going to drop to the bottom. The next layer is going to be silt. So you can see here, sand, silt, and then the topmost layer will be clay, and it's usually the lightest color of those three things. And an ideal ratio is going to be about 20% clay, 40% silt, and 40% sand. And you can see we're not meeting any of those ratios exactly here, but this gives me an idea of what I need to work on, what I need to amend with to fix our soils.
Thanks for watching, and see you next time.